Is Your Pastor Hypnotizing, Brainwashing You? That is the series. And the topic of today is Church Brainwashing and the Stockholm Syndrome. Okay, we're going to point one now. Point number one, Galatians 5:13. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty, only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. So we have been called to liberty, but what have our people, our so-called pastors, the so-called men of God, what have they done with the liberty that God has given to Christians? They have taken away the liberties. That is what the brother is trying to talk about, that don't go to Rotary Club, don't go to any other church, don't go to this. You have to belong to them. You have to pledge allegiance to their church. You have to pledge allegiance to them. What is that? That's brainwashing. But it is freedom. Nobody should tell you to go to church or not to go to church. It is your own personal relationship with God. If you want, you go. If you don't want, you don't go. And you are not supposed to, you know, pledge allegiance to any pastor. You are not supposed to pledge allegiance to any denomination. You can go there if you want. It's your heart. You follow your heart. You don't follow human being, and you don't listen to any human being that's controlling where you can go, where you cannot go. You see, he said, brethren, friends, fellow, you know, Christians, you have been called unto liberty. Don't trade your liberty in the name of miracle. Don't trade your freedom. Trade your freedom in the name of liberty. Don't give away your freedom. The people who take away freedom are people who are taking advantage of you. They are trying to hypnotize you so as to take away your freedom. They are trying to hypnotize you so as to, you know, make you surrender your will to them so that they will become your God and your Lord and your master. That is the purpose of brainwashing and hypnotizing. But then when you have already been hypnotized, if you are not careful, you will be the one defending and protecting them so that they will keep you more in slavery. But what they are supposed to do, the Bible says, you know, we have been called to liberty. Let your, no, but serve love, one another in love. It's supposed to be, they are supposed to be serving you in love, not, you know, asking for anything in exchange. Now, let's look at the dictionary definition for the Stockholm Syndrome. The dictionary definition is the hostages, so the victims and the experience, the victims experience a powerful, primitive, positive feeling towards their captor or predator. This is exactly what happens in our African concept. The same members, the so-called members, who are actually slaves. These members who are actually slaves, whose will have been subdued, whose freedom has been taken, whose money has been taken from them. They are the ones who primitively begin to feel positively towards these men of God and call them men of God, papa, mama, and pastors. But they are the ones oppressing them. They are the ones taking their money. They are the ones taking away their time. They are the ones not allowing them to spend time with their children and their wives and even fulfilling their own vision and their calling. But the Stockholm Syndrome is that the people who have been oppressed are the ones themselves who are defending the captor and the predator. They are in denial. These people who are in oppression and who are in captivity, they are in denial that this is the person who put them in that situation. They don't believe it. That you go and tell a Nigerian man that the church is the one that is the source of his problem. They will say, no, it's not the church, or it's Satan. It is Satan, demons and everything. Or it's even you yourself. Or their family. It is their family, the family who brought them up, who gave them everything. They will be saying it is the family to blame. But in their mind, they think this is the person who is going to let them live. They think this person is rather giving them life. But come to think about it, if you are going to church 5 days or 6 days a week, when do you have time to pursue your calling? When do you have time to spend time with your children? When do you have time to spend time with your daughter, with your son, with your wife, with your husband? When do you have time to pursue your calling? When do you have time to do self-education? When do you have time to grow? Okay, we have a caller. Yes, who is calling, please?
Hello, dear. Say good evening.
Good evening, David.
This is David speaking.
How are you, sir?
Oh, I'm doing wonderful. Bless God. Thank you very much for this eye-opening messages you are giving to us. As I'm talking to you right now, I'm in Nigeria, I'm in Anambra State, coming to Lagos this night, but I say I must watch this program. And tonight, it is another eye-opener again, because these people, what we are seeing in these churches in Nigeria today, they are all abominations.
Yes.
They are all abominations. And, you know, the annoying part is that people will know the truth, but they will know they don't want to accept. Somebody even from the former, I will call it former DSA family,
yes,
was even against DSA, was putting it online. When I read it, I said, God, what is this? So you see, we must keep on pressing the button, preaching it, they will hear it by force, by fire. I know very soon, many pastors are there watching, but they don't want to identify. But very soon, the fire don't catch it already, because I was in Anambra for almost 1 week now, and I know what God has done through there. And I know that much more are coming. DSA and family, we are going somewhere. We should keep on the good fight.
Thank you very much. Thank you so very much. Yeah, so, you know, the whole idea is that the people who are oppressing you, they are the one you'll be defending. Like this case now we are seeing here. You know, you'll be surprised that these same people who have been pushed down, they are thinking that the pastors are doing them good, because they have brainwashed them to tell them that they have Satan inside them. They have been told that it is they are the ones who are delivering them, and that they are the ones setting them free. But really, they are actually depriving them of their dignity, their human dignity. These people have been oppressed. They have been disgraced. They are being shamed to the world. I mean, if they really want to help them, why do they need the camera there? If they really want to help them, why do they need to disgrace them publicly like this? If they really want to help them, why don't they take them to the room? Why don't they cover their privacy? I mean, their identity. And why don't they help them in the silence when nobody is there? Why should they make them to be lying down in the ground and doing all this? This is all what we are talking about. People have been brainwashed, and then they will still take their money and go and give to these kind of people. You have a caller. Hello?
Hello?
Yes. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, go ahead and talk.
DSA.
Yes, please.
Yeah, the exact thing I want to raise is, I've been watching you for some time now, the video that you are bringing up this evening.
Yes.
I've asked myself, I was like, because I'm here in Europe as well, I've asked myself, I was like, how many Daddy Gios do we have in the entire Europe? Like the likes of those big pastors that we see in Africa, that you see a man of God throw a suit and people fall down. We don't see this kind of pastors in Europe. Why? And the Christianity that we are talking about came from Europe to Africa. So is it that Africa that cannot manufacture even spoon? Are the people now telling the us about the scriptures that the Europeans brought? You get what I mean?
Yeah.
These are the things I sit down to think. Like, Africa, we cannot manufacture anything. We don't produce anything. Everything we use is from here.
Yeah.
And we are so religious. How come the Europeans are no longer religious? And we are not so religious. Because each time I ask my colleagues were like, I was telling my colleagues that if I take salary, because I used to be a tither before, until I start listening to you. When I collect my salary, I tell them I still pay 10% to my church. They go like, after the government has taken tax, you still pay another money to church. Who takes the money in the church? Those are the questions they ask. I'm like, I give to God. But now I see that I look at myself, I look so stupid and foolish that I've been paying an individual my 10% of hard-earned money, and I will say I'm giving it to God, because God never came down to collect this money. I was paying this money to an account. God does not own an account. So, listening to you, the likes of, you know, these issues are issues that should be spread across Africa, because people have been in this mess for too long. Like, it's a big problem. These issues of Christianity, the way we are practicing Christianity, I'm even coming to realize that is it what is actually dragging us back as a people?
Yeah, it's not Christianity itself.
Listen, I once visited Jamaica.
Yeah.
Do you know that what is happening in Nigeria, church from pole to pole, is what is happening in Jamaica?
Yeah.
If you go to the ghetto, in a corner, you see like 10 churches. So I've come to realize that this issue has to do with everywhere, any nation you have black people, they are always very religious. And the easy way to take money from the poor is through the Bible. And you tell them, if they don't pay tithe, God is going to curse them. It's not written anywhere. The painful thing is that we have the Bible, we don't read it.
Yeah.
We didn't read it. It's so painful. And guys, man, thank you very much, Dr. Adelaga, for what you're doing. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Now, what is happening is not that it's Christianity that is the problem, but the problem is with the way Africans are practicing Christianity. This word of faith, this prosperity message, that is the thing that is causing us problem. It's not Christianity that's the problem. It's what they are preaching that's the problem. It's their interpretation of Christianity that's the problem. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello, good evening. How are you?
Evening.
Hello, can you hear me?
Very well.
Okay, good. How are you? Hope you're very well.
Very well.
Good. I only have one question for you.
Yes, sir.
Are there other pastors that share your viewers as well, and why aren't they speaking out if there are any? And also, what is the relationship between yourself and all these so-called, well, men of, yeah.
Yeah, I use,
men of whatever.
Yeah, I know all of them personally, on personal level, and I've spoken to a few of them, and I've spoken privately, and I've also spoken in their conventions. I've spoken openly and privately to many of them. Right now, I made a video and I said, my friends, you know, it's going to get worse. I'm going to go alone. I want to obey God. I don't care what anybody says. I am ready to lose every friend. So I cut off everybody just to do what I'm doing. So it's costing me all my friends. It's costing me all my relationship, but I would rather be loyal to God and do what God wants than to be having friends and relationship with all these people. I heard that there are many other men, really, remnants, who might be having the same views, but they are not, maybe they are not as radical, or they are not as bold, or they are not as, or maybe they said, what they tell me is, we don't have the platform, or we don't have the name, or we don't have the recognition. That's what the way they say it. And they said, okay, you have the clout, so you have the authority to speak. But they will not recognize us. We are nobody, you know, all those kind of things.
Yeah. Yeah, because the thing is, to be honest with you, a lot of things you say makes a lot of sense. And even I've actually shared some of your videos with certain people who thought they knew everything. And the funny thing is this, they actually agreed with everything you're saying. My only concern is your safety in Nigeria, because to be honest with you, I don't trust these guys one bit. Don't trust them, you know. So anyway, God bless you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Yeah, well, you know, it's a pity, you know, see what they are doing to people. They are brainwashing them and making, can you see this man, the way he's maltreating and mistreating this woman? And by the time the woman gets up, the woman herself will be the one defending him. And not just defending him, she will be taking the tithe and offering to him, and be calling the husband to follow her too. And be bringing all the relatives to also go to that same church. Despite all this maltreatment, and all this abuse that is you know, the what they are, even if they want to do anything, they shouldn't bring the camera. Why should they expose her to the whole world? Why is he beating her? Or slapping her, beating her anyhow, and then putting the microphone in her mouth and making her, you know, it is it is an abuse. It's a total abuse what they are doing. And I mean, they bring it, you see them with the microphone, you see what they are doing? And the reason why they are bringing the microphone there is to make sure that, to make other people hear, as if the woman is possessed, as if, see the way she is shouting, as if, so to show that they are powerful, they are anointed, they are the ones who have the power. So they are actually building their reputation on disgracing other people, on putting other people down. But then they make that, those people to think as if they are rather helping them, and they are the ones who are for them. So that's why where that syndrome comes from. The syndrome of people who are oppressing you, people who are disgracing you, who are taking advantage of you, you are the one later on believing them that they are your defenders and that they are your protectors. And then you begin to defend them. That is what this Stockholm syndrome is. Now let's go back to the notes. Okay, this is where we are. The Stockholm syndrome, the hostage and the victim experience, the victims and the hostages experience a powerful, primitive, positive feelings towards their captor or predator. They are in denial. And they say that this is the person they are in denial that this is the person who put them in that situation. They will not believe it, that this is the person who is the cause of their problems. In their mind, they think this is the person, rather, who is going to let them leave. So they are praising their predator, thinking that, saying that that is the person who is giving them life. So it's like the slave and the slave master. It's the slave defending the slave master. Now, the person being manipulated becomes a willing participant, you see? This is where it happened. All those people you are seeing on the floor, who are rolling on the floor, they are willing participants because of these wrong assumptions. Can we see some of the video? You see that they are willing participants. They are not running away. If they are not willing participants, they would have been running away. Can you show the video? Yeah, these videos also. Show us the videos. Let's see. You see that all these people are willing participants. You see, they are mistreating them, and some of them are even standing, still praying there, instead of all of them to leave that church and to call the police on the man. They are not calling the police on him. The woman is rather crying and thinking that, if the man is helping, the woman is crying, thinking that the man is a man of God. See the way the woman is mistreating her. And she is a willing participant. Why? Because she has been brainwashed. She has been brainwashed to think that a barrenness, because she came to have children. So they are telling her, for example, that's just an example, I don't know this particular case. So they are telling her that she cannot have children because she has spirit husband. Now, there's nothing like spirit husband in this world. But and they are telling her they are removing the spirit of husband. That's why they are mistreating her like that. So she is thinking they are really actually helping her. But this is rubbish. It is rubbish because it's just brainwashing and manipulation. It is so sad what is happening in this world. And these are churches. It's so sad that these things will be happening in churches. That churches are the ones who are taking advantage of people like this. You see what a pastor is doing to a human being. Nobody should do this to a human being. Even to a prisoner, you shouldn't treat a prisoner like this. Because they are depriving her of her dignity. Even if she is truly demon possessed, you don't have to. It's not the woman that is the demon. Demon is not physical. Demon has to be cast out without hurting the woman. Hello.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Oh, Monica, it's been a while.
Hello.
Yeah, nice to hear your voice.
This is Monica from London.
Yes, it's been a while. Nice to hear from you.
Yes, sir. Good evening. Thank you, DSA, for all you're doing.
Yeah.
I just want to contribute to this brainwashing thing you said about.
Okay.
I went to a church. I was invited to a church some time ago, and I was told that they're doing evening service. So, and they say it's going to start at 7. When we got to this church, and we waited, me and my daughter, we waited for like 2 hours. I said, when are they going to start? They said 9 o'clock. I said, how can it be 9? You said 7. But the man of God didn't come at the 9 o'clock anyway. So I just saw that people were now queuing. I mean, like he wanted, they said they are doing, what's it called, laying of hands. Because I wasn't told that, I was just invited for evening service. So suddenly I saw people now queuing and saying that they are going to do laying of hands. So I feel like people were just, when he lays hands, people just fall down and roll and all that. So I made up my mind that when it gets to my turn, I'm not going to fall down anyway. So when it gets to my turn, hello, are you there, sir?
Very well.
Yeah. When it got to my turn, I think he already knew that I'm going to be a stubborn person. So, and he just put his hand like this. It was like a lighting. That was how I fell down. When I fell down, in fact, I was so embarrassed. So I quickly stood up immediately. I just took my daughter and I ran out of the church. I never looked back. That was why I ran away. So I knew that there's something wrong in that place that like they're hypnotizing, bring what you don't. I don't really understand you until when I started listening to you. So that's just my contribution.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Yes. On point. So this is what they do. They hypnotize people. They want you to fall down so as to show that they are powerful. It's all about their power. It's all about them. It's all about, them captivating you, taking away your will, taking away your freedom, taking away your money, taking away your authority, making you feel subhuman and making you feel that they are the ones who own your life or who your joy depends on them. Your happiness depends on them. Your life depends on them. Okay, we have another caller here. Hello?
Oh, hello, sir.
Yes.
This is Feikemi from Canada.
Bless you, Feikemi.
Bless you, sir. I don't know if you're still going to come to this particular aspect of the brainwashing.
Yes.
There are some, they don't make you to fall down. You don't need to fall down. They tell you themselves you don't need to fall down. But they make you believe that they have been appointed by God for a specific purpose.
Yes.
And it's only through you, through them, that you can accomplish that. So they make you feel guilty if you don't go to them. And if you want to do anything, for example, they say they have the anointing for to make you for finance. So if you don't go to them, they now make you feel guilty. So whatever you do, you have to see them. So you see them as the Lord that is actually going to bring the money or that is going to make the finance go through. I don't know if you are still going to go to there because for now, a lot of them will tell you don't need to fall down. I'm just going to anoint you. I'm going to place my hand on you. If you want to come forward, I will transfer the anointing on you. They call it impartation.
And it's a lie because it is only God that blesses. It's not a man that blesses. And your prosperity and your blessing doesn't depend on a man at all. You just have they need to only teach about personal relationship with God. That's all. It's only God that blesses. The only God that is the blesser. It's not any man of God or any pastor.
So that's another, thank you, sir. That's another aspect of brainwashing. They tell you don't need, especially abroad, you don't need to fall down. They just tell you they have been the one called for this particular purpose. So you just keep on with that. So if you don't attend church, you feel guilty. You just feel, unless you are there and you are under the administration, nothing happens. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, that is also brainwashed, definitely. You are right. That is brainwashed because they take away your freedom and they make you feel that without them you can do nothing and that your prosperity and your blessing in life depends on them and that you have to come to. That's why in most churches they tell you must come to church, whereas you don't have to go to church. You only have to have personal relationship with God. And you have to go to church only when you feel like going to church or if you feel like going to church. But most important thing is not going to church. It's having personal relationship. It's knowing God. It is the knowledge of God that is supreme. That is what churches are supposed to be preaching. But instead of that, they are underlining and emphasizing other things. Hello?
Hello. Hello, good evening.
Yes.
I have a very important thing to say concerning this issue.
Yes, please.
In the afternoon, somebody said, you don't see all this kind of program for in a mosque.
Yes.
In the mosque.
Yes.
I want to use this medium to tell everybody in this platform that you first of all go and read 1 Corinthians chapter 5, 12 and 13. He said, it is not our duty to judge those who are outside the church, but it is certainly our duty to put those evil people away from the church, those who are outside and those who are inside. So I want to make this clear to everybody. who are saying that what you are doing, that you are fighting the body of Christ. You are not fighting the body of Christ. Rather, you are putting off the evil away from church.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yep. Let's go away. Let's go back to the class. So we go back to the point that we are making. You see here that in the case of hypnotism and brainwashing, after they have finished brainwashing you, the person that is the victim, you that they are brainwashing, you are so manipulated that you become a willing participant, like we just saw now. These people are willing participants because of this wrong assumption that these people, you know, the pastors are the ones your life or your blessing depends on. But really, your blessing depends only on God, not on man. So they are happy to go along with the advice and direction of the person or the pastor who is supposedly helping them. More so, when you come to church, you will see all kinds of leaders preparing you, all the people, assistant pastors, they call them all leaders. All these leaders and assistant pastors, they are preparing you. They are working on your mind. They are preparing you to be ready for the man of God. Really, it's all about a sort of hypnotizing. You know, I don't know, maybe some of you have witnessed that. When you come to church or they want to pray for you, you see all assistants. Somebody is holding you. Somebody is telling you to do this. Somebody is telling you, listen. They are prophesying to you. They say, oh, you must listen. You must say yes. You must. They are holding you. They pray for you. They are all kind of people. Or they are taking your name. Or they are registering you. It's all conditioning. It's all conditioning. These are all forms of manipulation and brainwashing that is happening. So the only thing that really matter that could help people and save people from this is the word of God. It is only the word of God. Your word is the truth. And your word, the Bible said, sanctify them with your word. We need to get people attached to the word of God. We need to help people be attached to Christ, to have personal relationship with God. We need to help people to know that only their personal relationship with God matters, not anything else. Nothing should come between them and their relationship with God. Not man of God, not church, not miracles, not wonders, just personal relationship with God. Okay. So this kind of manipulation is much more common in cults, churches, or in marriages where there is no gun put to your head, no gun put to anyone's head, and there may be no physical force or violence. You know, it's so subtle. So nothing is done to abuse you like with a gun or to rape you or to force you something physical. No physical force or violence being used. But that's why it's called brainwashing. It is when you are not having armed robber with a gun. You are not having some, kidnappers with some bombs. No, but it's just your mental. It is mental control. Manipulation is when they control your mind. You know, in churches, in cults, even in marriages it happens. You and a despot husband also manipulates the wife like that. Or a narcissist husband takes advantage of the wife and say, I'm the husband. I am your head, that's all. And since I'm the head, you cannot say anything. So this is the kind of manipulation we're saying. And it could get to a point that that wife that has been manipulated and subjected will begin to defend the husband. You know, although she is the one that has been manipulated. It's called, the Stockholm syndrome. And in some cases, the wife, the wife who is being oppressed will be the one, that is even encouraging the husband to do more of the evil things that he is doing because of the oppression of the mind. It's called manipulation, brainwashing. And these things happen mostly in churches and in courts and in marriages.